I found out, and I was not able to tell anybody, and I was crying for 10 days straight. It was great hearing this, you know, announcements, and getting back to this moment. It's, you know, priceless, really priceless. You know, my time in Boston was unbelievable, unbelievable. Even today, like 24 years later, when I come to Boston, I always meet somebody who recognize me and you know, welcoming you back, and it's unbelievable feeling, really.
To go to Robert, does Chief leans in, hooks it. Rolls out, tap, no, Raja, yes, and a foul.
I remember that it was my first game against New York Knicks. I remember I scored 15 points and got like 8 rebounds in my first game. And you know, you're a European, and people don't expect anything from you. And showing them in the first game that they can count on me, it was great. And, you know. Seeing Chief, he's so funny guy, you know, people think of him as a stone face, you know, he never have a reaction during the game, but after the game, before the game, he's a completely different person. And I love my 1 year, and I see Xavier McDaniel, he's a guy who I learned a lot from. He beat the crap out of me for a year, I learned so much from him. And then I hear the voice of Tommy Henson, who unfortunately died last year. So so many memories in this you know, one short clip.
I think Chris Ford should switch defensive assignments and maybe move Raja away from Clarence Weatherspoon so he doesn't pick up his sixth.
Here's Raja on the offensive end, getting inside.
I think this was the game when I scored my career high, 36, I think. And this is, you know, the classic move that I did a million times in my life. It was great, you know, to be able to do certain numbers in that kind of defense that was played in those years. It was much, much harder to score points, and they beat you up. I mean, there were guys that beat you up pretty good, you know.
Welcoming Dino to the Hall of Fame is Larry Bird. Ladies and gentlemen, Dino Radja.
I hope you guys have time because I'm about to talk a lot. it's unbelievable feeling. The moment when they told me, like 1 week before an announcement, I found out, and I was not able to tell anybody, and I was crying for 10 days straight. Because it's so emotional thing. It's so, you know, you first of all, I never thought about it. I never, during my life, my career, I never thought about that I'm gonna have such an honor even possible. And you know, I play in front of 5, 10, 33,000 people the most in my life. You know, nothing can surprise me. I can do it. But this moment, when you exit outside, in front of everybody, in front of all these big stars, and with Larry on my back, all this goes down to drain. And then this nervousness, I was just, you know, so hard concentrated not to say anything stupid. But it was an amazing moment, amazing. I cannot really explain you how emotional that was, and how this 3 days all together was you know, huge for me.